Sure.
When you lay it out there, how do you guys get your bait laid out just right past your bobber without it getting all tangled up on you? It seems like you might tangle up. Nah, not quite often.
Well, I have a little something that I do different.
Okay, which is?
I'll show you. That's weight.
Okay, yeah, that probably is just flop right now. But yeah, I've been watching this bitch just laid right now. A couple times I'll go out there and it's all tangled up, but you can't hardly avoid it, but that's a good idea.
It's also nice if there's lots of birds. Because when you cast it out there, it sinks quicker. And if you've got a herring that isn't swimming very well, the weight pulls the head down, and then when you pull it back,
it makes it more natural, sure. Yeah.
Okay. Well, if that doesn't catch a fish, I don't know what will. So what I do is I tie a 20-pound braided between my two hooks.
Okay.
And then I have the monofilament wrapped over the top of that.
Uh-huh.
And then I use a bait holder snell rather than just the straight snell.
Okay.
I use the bait holder. So that, and that, what that does is that keeps the, I was snapping them off every now and then.
Uh-huh.
Because the monofilament, when it comes right up to that there, it gets pinched the wrong direction and breaks the connection to the little fish. So that's why I use the bait holder, because then it's back further off.
Okay. Okay, nice.
Alright. Going your way. Scott.
Here, you got one.
Yeah.
And you got one too.
All right.
Yeah, little one, but 3 pounds.
Yeah, doing good. So.
I had to crank mine almost all the way up for that 10 pounder. He took off for 4 tons.
I know.
And that was really fun.
I know. One of them that I caught, it was the native, I think. He did the same exact thing, and he went way in the heck out there, and then he was swimming right at me. So I was running up the bank and reeling, and so all I could do was keep tension on the pole.
As far as you normally cast out?
Yeah, I don't have to go out a long ways.
Okay, they're in that little channel, right?
Yeah, I've caught them. Sometimes you'll catch them right as soon as it hits the water, but most of the time it'll hit usually about halfway in, or even right up to that little channel there. Yeah, you want to be, I like getting in where there's the tide change, going one way and then the other.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the best.
Yeah.
Okay, say hi to Sandy. I lost you for a second there, buddy. Yeah, I know. It feels good.